Ant keeping is all about getting a single colony to thrive. At the heart of each colony is the queen. Workers don't live very long, and only a fertilized queen can lay eggs. So without a queen, your colony will quickly die out. So step one in ant keeping is to get a fertilized queen. The colony goes through distinct stages in its life cycle. Your work as an ant keeper is to properly facilitate each stage. A new colony starts with the nuptial flight of a queen, where she mates with male drones. Only mated queens can lay eggs and start a new colony. The best way to get a mated queen is to catch one during the nuptial flight in the wild. Stay tuned for our upcoming video on how to do this. An alternative to capturing your own queen is to buy one. We highly recommend to catch one yourself, but buying offers an alternative route to starting your colony. We will dedicate a video to this topic as well. The queen is looking for a tight, enclosed space where she can start her empire in safety. This is called a nuptial chamber. We talked about this in more details in our main series. You can find the video here. An easy but effective way to create a nuptial chamber for your queen is to use a test tube, water, and cotton wool. We will upload a tutorial on how to do this in detail soon. So step two in ant keeping is to make a nuptial chamber for your queen and the first workers. If the queen is comfortable, she will start laying eggs. Soon, the first workers are born. These workers are small and initially focus on taking care of the queen, the nest, and the eggs and larvae. It will take a while before they venture out. So the nuptial chamber is sufficient for quite some time. It takes several months before the colony needs more space. The second stage comes when the colony is large enough to have experienced workers who are ready to venture outside of the nest. This is an exciting moment for every ant keeper. Now is the time to prepare a larger enclosure for your budding colony. We will talk you through everything you need to do to create a perfect formicarium in a separate video. Step 3 in ant keeping is to prepare a formicarium for your colony and place the nuptial chamber inside it. Your colony is now ready to survive. An established colony largely takes care of itself. The colony organizes itself, builds its own nest, and cares for their young. Ants are extremely clean creatures, so there is very little cleaning work left for you to do. As long as you provide enough food, the colony will do the rest. Step 4 in ant keeping is to maintain and enjoy your colony. Like all life, the colony does not last forever. Queens can last for 20 to 30 years, but when she dies, the colony comes to an end. Many ant keepers are not able to keep their colonies for their entire lifespan. We will talk about what to do if you can't take care of your colony anymore in a future video. Step 5 is to end your colony project well. This was a quick overview of the basic steps of ant keeping. There is also a wealth of information online if you have questions about topics we haven't covered yet. Both online and in our videos, you will find information about things that can go wrong and what to look out for. While it is good to keep these things in mind, our main tip for everyone starting out is don't panic. Remember, ants are survival specialists and they will work together with you to make this project work. When one of our producers first got into ant keeping, he read so much about all the things that can go wrong that he caught 13 queens in the hope that at least one would survive. Well, all of them did and started a colony. If you are keen to get started, subscribe to our channel and we will walk you through all the steps to start a thriving colony.